I think you all are good and staying at your home doing science work. Students, we were doing lesson number 3, fiber to fabric, and up to now we have completed that what are the importance of wearing cloth. And I have told you that the person wear clothes to protect itself from cold, heat, and rain and other things, isn't it? So we are wearing clothes to protect ourselves from all these things and to look good, isn't it? Then we have done brief history of clothing, that why early men start using this animal skin fur, all these things for wearing. Earlier he don't know that he should wear clothes. When by and by when he felt cold, heat, all these things, then he start using the animal skin, fur, leaves, grass, bark of tree, even bone also for covering its body. And type of fabric we were doing, and I have told you that we have different type of fabric for us for wearing at different occasion. For example, when you go to school, you are wearing your school dress, that is of different fabric. When you go to birthday party or when you are going to marriage, then you are wearing different type of clothes, isn't it? And when you are at home, then also you are wearing different type of cloth. So we have different fabric to protect us from cold, heat, rain and dust, isn't it? And we are not wearing the same type of fabric every time. Then from where we are getting this fabric, that is the sources of fabric that we have discussed. Students, I am just recalling you that what up to now what we have done. We have done natural fiber also. In under natural fiber, we have completed plant fiber and animal fiber. The fiber which we get from plant is called plant fiber, and the fibers which we are getting from animal is called animal fiber. For example, your fruit fiber, listen, fruit fiber is a type of plant fiber, okay? And these fiber we are obtaining from fruit of the plant. Then cotton, example are cotton and core, C-O-I-R. Core means coconut fiber. These are the seed fibers which we are getting from plant. Then the another fiber is bast fiber, B-A-S-T, bast. Bast means the fiber which we are getting from stem. Then leaf fiber, which we are getting from leaf. Then stalk fiber, which we are getting from straw. Okay, then seed fiber. Seed fibers are the fibers which are collected from seed. So we have 5 type of plant fibers. First one is fruit fiber, then bast fiber, then leaf fiber, then stalk fiber, and 5th one is seed fiber. Then we were talking about cotton, and I have told you that cotton is the world most popular plant fiber, which is a type of sharp and which required a black color soil for growth, warm climate and moderate rainfall. Okay, and I have discussed the process of this cotton, how the processing of cotton takes place. First one, the cotton plants bear fruit, that is called cotton bolls. When they are ripened, the bolls burst, exposing the seed surrounded by soft cotton fiber. First one is picking, then ginning, and then spinning. This we have completed. Now today we are going to do the properties of cotton. Why cotton is so much popular? It is soft fabric, shrink easily, and it is allow air to pass through. It absorb moisture, sweat also, and wrinkle, it get wrinkled easily. This is the disadvantages. then it needs lot of maintenance. Means for wearing this, we require lot of maintenance. Then it can be damaged by easily moth. But the good thing, what is the good thing with cotton? That it is biodegradable. Okay, so cotton fiber are what are the uses? If we see the uses, they are used for making clothes, bed sheet, curtains, towels and quilts. Okay, then nylon is an example of, if we track our process, then nylon is the example of tell but it is the example of artificial fiber. Cotton and silk are the example of natural fibers. Dash fibers are obtained from fruit. Which fiber we are obtaining from fruit? The fiber name was tell fruit fiber. Okay, the food fiber we are using. Then dash fiber are obtained from stem, that is the stem fiber we are obtaining from speak. What will be the answer? The stem we are obtaining from bast fiber, BAST, bast fiber. Then dash is a process in which involve separation of seed, that is you can say the first one process. The first process is after picking, the next process is ginning. Okay, from making the seeds out, that is your ginning, GINNING. Okay, so I think this track your process is clear to you. Now let us talk about jute. You must have seen jute plant, or you must have seen the things which are made up of jute fiber. Jute is also known as golden fiber due to its golden nature, golden color, and it is a natural fiber. And do you know that jute plant need high temperature and plenty of rainfall to grow? It grow best in the soil that contains sand, silt and clay. So alluvial soil is the best suited for cultivation of jute. In India, we are growing it in nearby this Sundarban deltas. Okay, so it is in India is the largest producer of jute fiber, and the process of obtaining jute yarn from the plant is first one is, if you see, retting, RETTING. The harvested stack of the plant are soaked in water for few days until they start rotting, ROTTING, and this process is called retting. Okay, this retting softens the bond between the fiber and the inner core, and the separation of this fiber now become more easier. The fibers are then separated from the rotting stem, and then the fiber are made from yarn by twisting the strands together. This process is called spinning. So I think up to here each and every thing is clear to you all. So in our next video we are going to read the properties of jute. Okay, so till then, thank you. Have a nice day.